Greetings again from Territorial Headquarters here in London. The headquarters here at Elephant Castle are very, very quiet, as you might expect. The building, 9 stories high, houses well over 300 people normally, but today there's just a handful of people in the building. When I am here, I do walk all of the floors just to remember each of the members of staff and just to see what might be happening. It's an interesting walk through those dark and quiet corridors. I always take a little bit longer, however, at the International Projects Office, because there they've got chocolate for sale and I feel it my duty to help them. And I always find myself trying to get rid of, as one might say, the amount of chocolate that is there, which raises funds for our international development. I'm rather hoping that in the not too distant future, there'll be more members of staff to help me, because it's costing me an absolute fortune as the amount of chocolate is reduced and is consumed. There's a lot of talk and a lot of hope just at this time that things might come back to normal. However, I want to suggest to you that back to school, back to work, back to worship is a concept that is not really going to happen. The world has changed forever. COVID-19 has secured that for us. It's as if a fast forward button has been pushed in terms of the acceleration of change that we are normally in. And the change which might have taken us maybe years, decades even, have suddenly accelerated over a very short period of weeks. And so when we think about going back, I'm saying to you that it's probable it won't be back to how we thought it was or how we remembered it was. Obviously, there are some things which we desperately hanker after. There are so many things which we want to have back. The opportunity to meet with our families, the opportunity to hug our grandchildren, the opportunity to do some of the normal things of life, to hang out and to go down to the coffee shop or to go to the cinema or go to the theatre, go to a concert, and of course, gathering together as a Salvation Army, as the church on Sundays. However, I prefer not to think of us going back, but I want to put it to you that we should be thinking about going forward. Forward into worship, forward into work, forward into the world. Henry Alford penned these words that are found in the Salvation Army songbook. I have to confess to you, until I looked this up just today, I kind of thought that Henry Alford, who wrote these words, must have been a Salvationist. But I see at the bottom of the page that he died in 1871, so he would have been cutting it very fine. Henry Alford, I understand now, through a little bit of research, was the Dean of Canterbury Cathedral, a place I know very well. For many years, I served on the Canterbury Cathedral Council. And Henry Alford penned these words that many of us will know very well. Forward be our watchword. Steps and voices joined. Seek the things before us, not a look behind. Burns the fiery pillar at our army's head. Who shall dream of shrinking by our captain led? Forward through the desert, through the toil and fight. Jordan flows before us, Zion beams with light. And the second verse continues in a similar vein. Forward, flock of Jesus, salt of all the earth, till each yearning purpose springs to glorious birth. And so the verses go on. Henry Alford wrote these as a processional, as the clergy and the choir would enter from the front of the cathedral and would walk their way down the length of that glorious building. Great set of words. Forward, says Henry, seek the things before us. The language is a little bit dated, I get that, but the essence and of the message is the same. We're called to go forward. We're called to be a people who are called to step up and to step forward, and by essence of that, to be freed up. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 13, We read of a lady who was healed by Jesus. It's not a commonly read episode in the Gospels, but I want to read it to you today because it talks about going forward, and it's at Luke's Gospel chapter 13 and verse 10. On a Sabbath, Jesus was teaching in one of the synagogues, and a woman who had been crippled by a spirit for 18 years was there. She was bent over and could not straighten up at all. And when Jesus saw her, he called her forward and said to her, "Woman, you are set free from your infirmity." Then he put his hands on her, and immediately she straightened up and praised God. Indignant because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath, the synagogue ruler said to the people, "There are 6 days for work, so come and be healed on those days, not on the Sabbath." And the Lord answered him, "You hypocrites, doesn't each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or donkey from the stall and lead it out to give water? Then should not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has kept bound for 18 long years, be set free on the Sabbath day from what bound her?" Last week, if you were listening, I reminded you of some wonderful words of Jesus as he spoke the words of the prophet Isaiah in Luke chapter 4. And it echoes what we've just read from Luke 13. Jesus said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he's anointed me to preach good news to the poor, sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to release the oppressed," I hope you remember that, "and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." Here is this woman who was asked to step forward, and in stepping forward, found in the name of Jesus and in his very presence, a healing and a release. And I believe that the pandemic, these weeks in which we've been locked down, has given us the space and the opportunity to again be a forward-looking people. It's a reminder to me that we need to be freed up. We need to be released from a mindset that has conned us into thinking that being army, being the church, is more about when we meet together as opposed when we are dispersed. Great that we come together. I'm missing it desperately. But the essence of the gospel and the essence of mission is that God is a sending God. He sends us, missio, to be sent out into the world, forward into the world, as salt and light, released to be bringers of hope, of salvation, of joy, of service, of love and of healing. A people who intentionally live the Jesus lives in our own houses, in our own streets, in our own community, in our own work, in our own schools, and in our own universities, wherever it is we are. Of course, it's great that we come together, but the power of the gospel is lived out when you and I go out and live out our lives wherever we are. I think this time of pandemic has brought that back to us and given us opportunity to reassess what it is to be in the mission and service of God. Living the gospel, gossiping the gospel, as one theologian once said we should do, being people of the word. And because we are people of the word, not neglecting critical matters of the kingdom, as Jesus reminded the Pharisees, as we read in Matthew 23 and verse 23, not neglecting justice, mercy, and faithfulness. It's echoes of the prophet Micah, who said, and I'll quote from Micah chapter 6 and verse 8, "He has showed you and me, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly before your God." We're called to be Jesus' people. We're called to act justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly before him. If the song that I quoted to you earlier is a little bit aged, I want to leave you with some words of the songwriter Tim Hughes. And it connects with what we've been thinking about over these last couple of weeks since Pentecost, this great joy of the Holy Spirit coming upon the Lord's people, filling us up, emptying us, first of all, cleansing us, purifying us, our sin, the dregs of our life, emptied out as we confess our sin before him, and then being filled with his love and light, being filled with his Spirit. Remember, being filled, a present continuous tense, in order that we might be who Jesus always wanted, called us, designed us to be. Tim Hughes writes these words: "Fill us up, but send us out. God of justice, Saviour to all, came to rescue the weak and the poor, came to serve and not be served. And Jesus, you've called us. Freely we've received, now freely we will give. We must go, live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. We must go, stepping forward, keep us from just singing, move us into action. We must go to act justly every day, loving mercy in every way, walking humbly before you, God. You have shown us what you require. Freely we've received, now freely we will give. We must go, live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. We must go, stepping forward, keep us from just singing, move us into action. We must go." So, may we all ask the question, Lord, what do you require of us? What do you require of me? What is it, Lord, that you want me to be? And then what do you want me to do? And I ask the question, Lord, what do you require of us, the Salvation Army, in these days? And as we look forward and as we step forward into this next accelerated chapter of history, that God is inviting us to walk with him. May you, may I, and may we have the courage to be obediently stepping forward with him day by day for the glory of God, for the service of our people who are in our communities, as we stand with them and as we live out the Jesus life. So have a good week. Keep stepping forward. Even though we can't sing together, may we know the joy of the Holy Spirit working through us for his praise and for his glory. May God bless you. Thank you.